Hello everyone, welcome to part 4 of advanced ecom series in Laravel 6. In this video we are going to work on admin login page. In last video you have seen that we able to work on dashboard page and we have made this dashboard page for our admin panel, and in this video we are going to make admin login. Okay, so let's start. First of all, I am going to search the login page from our folder, AdminLTE folder. It's located in pages examples folder. Here you can see login.html file. You can open this file and you can view that this is the admin login page we want for our Laravel 6 admin panel, Laravel 6 e-commerce admin panel. Okay, so this page we are going to merge in our Laravel 6 website. The process will remain the same like we have done for dashboard, and this admin login we will also do in the same way. So I am going to open, first of all I will show you dashboard. This is our dashboard page, and in the same way we are going to create admin_login.blade.php file. So first of all we are going to create the route for our admin login page. So here I am going to create the route for admin login. Going to copy this one and we'll paste it here. Okay, so I'm going to create see here, for dashboard we have make get, but for admin login we are going to use match because both get and post are required. So I am going to do like this. I'm going to add both get and post here. Here just slash will come and here login will come. Okay, so this is the route for our admin login. Both get and post we are using in this admin login route. See, we have used get just to show to user that admin login page, and we have used post whenever user is going to submit username and password, going to login with username and password, then the role of post will come whenever the form will submit and it will come to that submission. So that is required at that time. So now we are going to create a login function in AdminController blade file, AdminController. Here we are going to create login function. And we are going to return to admin login page. We are going to create this page in resources folder. We will go to our Laravel folder, e-commerce folder, in fact e-com folder. So I will check here resources, views, admin, and here we are going to create one file, admin_login.blade.php file. We are going to create this file. So if you are in Windows you can simply right click and create the new file. You can create a txt file first and rename to admin_login.blade.php file, but here in Mac I am going to create it like this. such admin underscore login dot play dot php file. Okay, so we can see that the file is now created. We can open this file here. Now I can copy the template. I will check the template. Here you can see in pages examples folder, this is our template. So we are going to open this one. I'm going to open this one in Sublime itself. Okay, so this is the login.html template provided by AdminLTE. And we require this template, so this HTML file, I am going to copy this HTML file. And here, see, we are not going to add header footer, we are not going to add admin design to this file like we have created in admin dashboard. We have added admin layout in admin dashboard, but we are not going to add that admin layout, because admin layout is only for the internal pages of the admin. It's not for the admin login page, okay? Because admin login does not require any kind of header, does not require any kind of footer. See, I will show you. This is the header part. It does not require this kind of header part here. And it also not require this kind of footer part. And it also not require this kind of sidebar. So admin login page is the simple, only this panel is required and nothing else. So we not required to attach admin login design, sorry, admin design to this file. So we will not add any kind of design. We will not extend admin layout. Okay. So we will keep it simple. I will just copy this one. This complete code I'm going to copy and going to paste this one in admin login blade file. And here I'm going to sort out the path. I'm going to add the URL for our Laravel URL for our path, and then it's going to start working. Okay, so let's do it. Path I'm going to create like plugins and all, we can do all together like this. Here we also need to add codes. Okay, so for CSS and JS as well. See, we will remove from here. Here it is not required. And for JS as well. Okay, so now our page is ready. Now we can check. See, its route is also ready. Its function is also ready. So we can simply open here without dashboard. We will open like this and we will see here. See, some issue is coming. Syntax error, unspecter index 3 expecting. We are going to check. Okay, this one index 3.html. So we are going to sort out the issue here. Here it is required like this, and this one is not required. We can make it like this, and same thing here. See, its CSS is not coming, so we are going to check out the CSS as well. See here, path needs to be corrected. It is CSS, after that front, admin underscore CSS, and after that this will come. So we are going to check again. See now, AdminLTE admin panel, we have now able to create the admin login panel. Okay, here you can also see sign in with Facebook and Google, but it is not required for the admin panel. So we can remove the unwanted things. We can remove all this. We don't want to register a new. See, this panel is for front users as well, but we are not going to use this. We will use our own front template. Okay, and this is for admin panel. So this much data is not required. Okay, so I am going to remove this one. So this one I can remove because these all are required. We will do sign in with Facebook and Google login in this advanced series, but we are going to do this for the front end, not for the admin panel. Okay, because it is not required in admin panel. So I'm going to remove this unwanted code. Also, we don't require forgot password, that also we can remove. New membership also not required. This much code we can remove. Now we will check once again. Okay, so this is the login panel for the admin, and here you can replace AdminLTE. Also you can give your own name or of your project name. You can give in fact you can give admin panel also instead of AdminLTE. You can give admin panel like this. Okay, so our admin panel login is ready for our Laravel 6 website. Okay, but in next video we are going to work on guards. Okay, we are going to work on multi-auth, and we will use guards for our admin panel, for our admins. Okay, for our admin and sub-admins, we can say. For our admins we are going to use guard, and for users we are going to use default auth. Okay, so don't miss next video. That next video is really important. We are going to make some changes in our Laravel settings. We can say Laravel, some of the files we are going to update for guard. Okay, so multi-auth basically we are going to start working on in next video. Okay, so stay tuned for that. And if you have any queries, you can surely contact me in video description. Okay, so that's all for now. Have a nice time. Goodbye.